now that we've covered an extensive part of your background, your career, for the audience and for the people that are listening today, besides all the nuggets that you already thrown out there, what would be your advice to a younger you? And what has changed? What is it? I know you explained a little bit, but what's the perfect advice? Or
if I was giving advice to a younger version of me, it would be more of like, be relentless, educate yourself, and tap into that mindset of like, I'm gonna go through this wall and I'm gonna F this thing up.
That's what's up.
So like, I felt like I've been reading this book, David Goggins, Can't Hurt Me. So what the book preaches is about creating calluses in your mind, which is, you know, a callus is like, you know, when you go hitting, when you hit the first week, your hand hurts. But once you start hitting every week and every day, the pain goes away. So you create a callus. Mm-hmm. So it's like creating callus in your mind about the soft shit that you do. So it's like you start running this mile and it's like, yo, this mile sucks. But then you keep running and it's like it becomes a little bit easier. Yeah. But then you get to like mile four and it's like, yo, it hurts. Like my feet hurt. Yeah. I'm not used to this. But when you start creating these calluses in your mind, you're able to fight through the pain. So what I would have told myself as a younger athlete is like, work harder. Like go the extra mile. Don't go against, like, you know, with the coaches. I feel like sometimes a lot of players, I always hear stories like, oh, the coach didn't like me.
I didn't play
because my coach was racist. But then the nine guys that are on the field, there's like five of them that are Hispanic. So it's like, how's your coach racist?
I don't think he was that racist.
Yeah, exactly. So you hear guys that come back from college with those stories, and it's like, it's not making any sense. Yeah. So when you start reading books and, you know, tapping into your mind, you start holding yourself accountable. So it's like, but David Goggins preaches, like, looking at yourself in the mirror and telling yourself, like, listen, this is what we got to work on. Like, you know, like, and I feel like I did that as a kid, but now as an adult, is popped a light bulb in my head. That it's like, yo, Dario, you know, you're going to go into your 30s and, you know, I don't want to say that my savings are in order, but your savings want to be to a point that when you bring a woman into your life, that everything is correct. Absolutely. That because sometimes divorces happen because as a man, your financials, you can't really provide, and it creates that stress in the household. And when you create that stress in the household, you're not focusing on love anymore. You're just focusing on maintaining.
Survival.
Exactly. So like, my goal now is like, you know, going into my relationship that I've been in for 7 years, is when she comes out of grad school, when she's going to, like, medical program, when she's all done, that I'm good. And it's like, yo, I got this, you know, look for a job. You don't gotta worry about the bills. At least for now.
Yeah, I'll cover it for now.
So like, that's the mindset I'm on.
Absolutely.
And then like, long term goal is like looking at my mom and like, you know, making sure that she's good for retirement. Because as you know, as we all know, like, coming from a Hispanic community and like even an African American community, or, you know, there's just like a low income community, you don't really focus on retirement.
There's
just be like, yo, I'm gonna focus on the Social Security. I'm gonna get a Social Security check. And you're not. That's the mindset that messes everybody up on that. The dependent. The dependent mindset. That's what creates the problems, the issues of like, people not growing, because you're so dependent that everything is gonna be taken care of for you, and that's not reality.
It is not.
And you know, for some people, they make it their reality, but it's not. And when you accept that, you start taking yourself to the next level. Yep. And you start taking your work to the next level. And when you start taking your work to the next level, you take your family to the next level, and what's coming behind it. And I'm not even talking about a financial sense. Cause some people, like me, I like money. I enjoy having money, but I don't really care for money. And I always told my best friends about that.
Yeah.
It's like, yo, listen, like, you know, I care more for my mental health. Like, if today I have 20 showings, but I'm gonna take care of it in a sense, but tomorrow I might take a break. Just because mentally I'm fried, and I need to take this step back.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes when you work for somebody, you can't really do that because that person is relying on you. But you could take that step back and be like, yo, listen, I'm going to come in late. Like, yo, today, you know, I need this.
Yeah, I need something for me.
Yeah, exactly.
Very important, guys. So step back and doing things for yourself.
It's for yourself. Like, you got to take care of yourself. Like, if you're mentally fried and you need a week off, like, ask for it. And like, they always say, even in the Bible, it says, if you ask, you shall receive. So don't be that person that's not asking for you know, for blessings or for upcomings and stuff like that.
Don't try to get it. Don't think that things are gonna come by easy. You know?
Exactly.
You gotta work hard.
Like,
for it.